Your PC is spying on you. It phones home every day, sending your personal info and ratting on your private activities directly to the company that makes Windows, Microsoft. And Microsoft knows what you're doing, but how do they know who you are? Because whenever you set up your new computer, you're prompted to sign in into your Microsoft online account. Today, we're going to be taking a look at how to set up Windows 11 without signing into that account. Instead, we'll be creating a local account, a username and password that allows you to log in to this computer only. To do this, you'll need a few things. First, you'll need either a brand new PC or a PC with a fresh install of Windows 11 on it. You'll know you've met this condition if you're greeted with this screen upon booting the PC. Second, you'll need a wired internet connection and the ability to disconnect it during the setup process. A wireless connection could work, but you'll have to switch off your Wi-Fi completely instead of simply unplugging a cable. Finally, you'll need to make sure your computer is connected to a power source, such as the charger or power cord that came with it. In the case of a desktop tower, you'll also need to connect a monitor, keyboard, and mouse. Now that we've got everything ready, it's time to power on our PC. Go ahead and press the power button. The location of the power button may vary, so consult your PC's enclosed instruction booklet if you're not sure where it is. You'll first be presented with a lovely little screen that Microsoft uses to seal away your rights and prevent you from suing them. If you'd like to know how many firstborn children you'll be signing away today, feel free to scroll through this text over here. Otherwise, simply click Accept. Now we're going to pick a name for our device. In most cases, I recommend naming it based on the device's intended use, location, or owner. Since I have multiple devices in this room already, I think I'll name this thing Valorant, because that's what I intend to use it for. And we'll click Next. At this point, your device may reboot. That's okay, the same thing happened to me, and everything turned out just fine. Pretty soon, you'll come upon this screen. When you do, click the back arrow here in the upper left-hand corner of the window. At this point, you'll want to go ahead and unplug your internet cable or turn off your Wi-Fi as appropriate. Then click Next on the screen you just returned to. If your internet was successfully disconnected, you should see this screen instead of the one we saw before. This will guide us through the process of creating a local account. First, it'll ask us to enter our name. Pro tip, you can enter any name you want here. You could enter your nickname, role in the family, or even your CB handle. I think I'll put in my YouTube handle, and we'll click Next. Next, we'll create a password. For this one, you don't have to use capitals, symbols, or anything ridiculous like that. Just make it something that's easy for you to remember, and that wouldn't be easy for the average person to guess. You'll be asked to type it in one more time just to make sure you remember it. Then you'll be prompted to select some security questions and provide answers to them. You'll need to know these answers in case you forget your password. Next up, privacy settings. These are set to maximum creep level by default, sharing your physical location, activity, and even your keystrokes with Microsoft. Turn everything here off, then click Accept. After a custom screen or two, which will vary based on which company made your computer, you'll see this screen. Follow its instructions and watch the pulsing blues. It's very relaxing. Once Windows is finished doing its thing, you'll be presented with the Start menu. If this menu disappears, you can return to it anytime by pressing the Start button here. But for now, go ahead and click Edge. Deselect the checkbox and click Confirm and Start Browsing. On the welcome screen here, I'm going to select a dark theme to make it a little easier on the eyes. And then I'm going to go to the address bar up here and type in NINITE.com. And this is where I realized I've forgotten to plug in my internet cable or turn on my Wi-Fi. Go ahead and reconnect your internet now as appropriate. Now we're on the NINITE website. NINITE is a free batch installer that allows you to install some commonly used programs on your new PC and update them simply by running the same batch installer again. You can select any combination of programs on this list to create your custom batch installer. If you're not sure what a particular program is, just hover your mouse over it for a brief description. For newcomers, I recommend selecting Chrome for browsing the web, Zoom for video calls and conferences, VLC for playing music and videos, OrphanView for looking at pictures, Foxit Reader for opening PDF files, LibreOffice as a free alternative to the Microsoft Office programs, and Malwarebytes to supplement Windows' built-in anti-malware components. Once you've made your selections, scroll down and click Get Your Nynite. The Nynite installer should begin downloading in this little doohickey right here. Go ahead and click it so the installer will automatically run when the download is finished. If prompted, allow the installer to run. We'll come back to it when it says Finished. While we're waiting for that to finish up, we're going to go to the Start menu, click Settings, click Time and Language, then select your time zone. Go ahead and close the settings now. Once Nynite says Finished, we're going to go ahead and restart the computer. To do this, click the Start button, click this Power button, then click Restart. Wait for the computer to restart, then log in when prompted. And that's it! You're ready to use your new computer. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and subscribe to the channel by clicking the red subscribe button below this video and logging into your Gmail account if prompted. In fact, you can use your new PC to do that right now. How fun! As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.